Namaskar, Namaste, welcome back to the second module in the MOOC course, Research Ethics, Anti-Plagiarism, Issues and Tools. Yesterday we have discussed about the overall course structure in the previous module and also we have given the definition of plagiarism in detail, followed by I showed you about four types of plagiarism, and we have focused to be honest in research is the most important things to do, but we can still avoid plagiarism if you take little care on preparing your research topic by using some of the tools in the research topic and also using, if you want to copy, how to use proper citation styles. So today we are going to discuss more about how to avoid plagiarism. This will be focused on three factors and each factor will be discussed in detail in other modules. In order to avoid plagiarism at the design or thinking stage itself, use a design thinking process about your project. That process will talk about various steps involved. You may also use reference management tools and use proper citation style. And let us see how this is going to help. I will give introduction to all these tips, then move to more on to how to avoid plagiarism. Using design thinking process, that is to avoid plagiarism at the design level, we can think about at the thinking process itself, keeping track of all the literature at the time of literature review, and observe what is happening in the domain. Ask questions yourself about the project and about the research and try to identify the gap in the research and find where is unresolved problem. Then focus on creating an innovative solution in the research area. So how these different steps are taken at the time of research, we will cover in another module in detail, but I am telling all this factor is there to avoid plagiarism. Now, another care is that while taking your literature, design thinking process, you are jotting down lot of queries, lot of content from other articles. So this has to be properly managed in a reference management system. So use of that reference management system. Right now, please do not think because we have 15 modules to cover in detail everywhere, but you can think of one reference management tool or two. Generally, people are very interested to use the tools like Mendeley, Zotero, etc. Now, these are the free tools as you can see from the screen. Zotero and Mendeley is free, then there are other paid also subscription based solutions, and some of these tools we will be giving you in hands on sessions so that you will not commit mistake in citing something. Now let us say no to the plagiarism, or let us be very skeptical about appearing plagiarism in our article. For that, what are the steps to notice while proceeding our research? So there are four major points which one can focus to avoid plagiarism. That is, the better way is that whenever you are reading article, read something, put it in your own words. The first and foremost points. That means the content will go to my mind and I will try to understand and I will put it in my own words. This is the first point. Another way I have to take somebody's content, but I cannot alter much in this. Then the way is credit the author, what you read, and not taking credit of what you are talking right now about that portion. So that means you are going to credit or acknowledge the author. There are different ways to do that. We'll see that later. And if you feel that you can't change even a single word what is said about the topic by somebody, sometimes this appears when you are quoting definition, when you are taking formula, we can't change much in that formula and definition. So in such cases, use quotation mark, the double quotes followed by who said it. Or the final way, which many people follow. At the beginning of the first sentence itself, in which you are going to quote, paraphrase or summarize, make it very clear that what comes next is someone else's idea. It's not yours. So see that I have taken these 4 points from this website where I have avoiding plagiarism, where I have given the Northwest States an education site. So I have given the credit there. It's not mine. So in a paper also we have to follow the same ethics or same kind of mechanism. And if I am putting all these points in an elaborated way, or many times I say that in that last 2 days, this is the best slide I am using. So if you follow all these points, bulleted points put in this, there will not be any chance of plagiarism coming in the later. You don't need to use any tool at all if you are properly following it. Now, first one is the attribute difference, which we have already discussed. Second, describe all sources of information which is leading to your project. It could be an interview, it could be an article, it could be a discussion, or it could be some idea appeared in a movie or whatever. All sorts of information which has used or which has some kind of relation with your research project, please note it down and describe that. Then give acknowledgement depending on the priorities. If you are using some core idea from a paper or another, it is better that you put it in the footnote itself. So in the every page has a footnote. When I am showing my page, I will show you where the footnote appears. So you can put it in the footnote. Generally it appears with the author, comma, year in the bracket, and at the end of the line, footer, you will mention that where it is taken. So the core idea taken in a page can be given in the footnote. And use quotation mark wherever is required. That means you are not altering. Remember, when you are using quotation mark, never ever change a single word in the sentence. Because quotation mark has to be as it is. We don't have any liberty to change that. Then another crude way of doing is that paraphrase the original attributed work. I will come about the paraphrasing later. And if you want to use extensive quotation, which generally happens when you are dealing with literature research, you have to quote Shakespeare, you have to quote Wordsworth, or Wordsmith, or anyone, Sheets, Kelly, you are doing a research on any of the poet, you can't change that quotation or lines or stanza they have used. For that, try to use the quotation, as well as if a quotation is going to more than in a permissible level, take permission from the publisher. 99% publisher will give you permission. There could be very small chance when you are using some core sales data or which is used for commercial purpose, some publisher may not agree, but otherwise you will get permission even if you are asking for using extensive quotation or data. Or avoid self-plagiarism. Self-plagiarism is quoting my yesterday in the last module we discussed it. Avoid self-plagiarism by taking permission from the publisher of the previous article authored by you. It is my article, but it is already published. So I ask permission from the publisher, even though I have the copyright of the article, but to use it somewhere else, I still need to ask permission from the publisher. And for published drawing and other illustrations, use permission from the agency who has done that. So these are, in nutshell, the best ways to follow to avoid plagiarism when we are dealing with an article or academic publication. Thank you, and I'll come back again. Stay tuned for the next